The Tai Chi walk.
Yeah.
Okay, start with a V. You got it, okay there. Yeah, all the weight is like that. So you just put the heel down, and then you just do the ward off. So you ward off. Forward. Then drag that one towards the heel, put it down. And ward off. Up, take it up, put it down, toss the heel, pull off. And then pull it there, put it down, pull off. Pull it back, take it down, pull off. You got quite a few moves already, yeah. So you can be walking for quite far. I think that should be good. They call it a Tai Chi walk.
So on the, when the rear foot comes up,
yeah.
Is that when you have your weight on the outside toes?
Yeah. So like that, you see the first one is, see you walk like that. See? And then when you go on tiptoe for a second or so, and then pull this one towards the heel.
Yeah, yeah.
Take a step. Put this one down, bring this one up. See? Then you pull this one towards the heel. Take a step. Put this one down. The reason why we pull it towards the heel is to feed back your own energy to the heel. If a person is sick and cannot do too many moves, this is the best one. See? Just pull it towards the heel and then take it directly out. Change. And then pull it towards the heel again. Take it directly out. Change. That feeds the energy back to yourself.
Does your toe actually touch the heel?
Yeah, you can touch the heel as you drag, you know, like that.
Right.
See, and then you put it on there, see, drag, see, toss the heel, and then out. It is a 90 degree angle. The footing is on a 90 degree angle. When it goes to the side, it's 90 degree. Like that. And when you pull it like that, you take it another 90 degree, like that. It's always a 90-degree angle.
That keeps the meridians open?
Yeah, so then your body is always square to where you are going.
And is it like those balancing the three physical
elements? Yes,
so
that's right.
So you don't go
that's
too far over your knee? And
that's right. That will give you the correct footwork and coordination with the handwork.